Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video we are going to discuss about the inconsistent formula error. So whenever you will face this error, you will find a pop-up which will say your formula is inconsistent. So in today's video I'm going to share three methods with you by which you can resolve this error. So stay tuned with this video as the method 3 which I'm going to share is going to be the easiest method. So let's go to method number 1. So what you can do is click any cell in this column or anywhere and come to the formulas tab at the top and select show formulas. Now what this will do is it will show the formulas that are at the back end of your numbers. So instead of the numbers you will start seeing the formulas. So I see what I have done is I have added the numbers in the cell A4 and B4, that is the cells next to next are added to get the total marks. And the error I have done here is, firstly, I have subtracted my values. And the second error I have done is I have not selected B5 and instead I have selected B6. So what you can do is you can come here and just change it. Okay, so now it seems there is no error. Now to get back your values, what you have to do is you have to click back on your show formulas button. And now you see that the error disappears. So this was method number 1. So in method number 2, what you have to do is click on any cell which doesn't contain the error. So suppose I select cell C4 which doesn't have the error, and then going into the formulas tab, I click trace precedence. I get some blue arrows. Now I click on the cell which gives the error and again click trace precedence. Now it gives some blue arrows. Now what you can do is you can match these arrows. What is going wrong? So you see that in cell C4 it says it took cell A4 and B4 and calculated the result, but in cell C5 it took cell A5 and B6 to get the result. That means we took wrong references of cell. So this is the second method which will help you know where is your error lying. So once you resolve it, then you have to click remove arrows to get rid of these blue arrows. Okay, and now let's come to method number 3, which is the easiest method. So what you can do is, now if you know that in your column you are maintaining a consistent formula, that is the first cell from the first cell to the last cell of your data, you are using the same pattern in your formula. If you know that, what you can do is just click on this yellow icon, the pop-up that comes up, and say copy formula from above. So it is as simple as that. It just copied this formula from the above cell and it removed my error. So but this method will only work, and you should only use this method when you know that all the cells are using the same pattern of formula. So these were 3 methods by which you can resolve the inconsistent formula error. So I hope this video helps you and you are able to resolve your error in your sheet. And let me know in the comment section if you have any question. I will help you in resolving those errors. Thank you for watching this video and please subscribe to my channel. Bye bye and have a good day.